Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and I am so happy. Finally, we can do some spring trimming. It's nice out. It's pretty much the danger of frost, deep frost, is gone. We still have some mornings when it's really cold and there are some ice, there is ice on the puddles, but these guys are strong and they can stand it. Now, as you can see, this is sedum. This is the old kind of sedum that people say, well, it's just so messy, it flops over. Well, this is what's left from winter, and I'm going to tell you a way to keep it from flopping. But first of all, I need to get rid of these old ones, and you can see that the new growth is already starting underneath. Those probably have been green since February. It's now April. Now you may wonder, well, why in the good heavens did I leave them up so tall? Well, it's easier in the fall. You're tired of gardening and you just sometimes want to be done. So you leave them up, and then the leaves collect in them and the snow collects in them, and it helps be a blanket for your perennials. Another plant that I'm going to be working on today is the giant fleece plant. Now these get to be 6 feet tall, but you see in the spring you can't even see any growth coming out right now. And they have these kind of like a bamboo stem to them, and they get beautiful white flower heads that smell like leather. Now this is probably, I probably trim this one maybe once or twice during the year because it does get so very tall, and sometimes it does like to flop over, so I give the wayward ones a little haircut. But this is how I leave it in the fall. Again, I'm tired of gardening in the fall. It's nice to just be able to say, okay, go to sleep now. And it catches leaves and snow in the bottom so that it protects the roots again. Now I can tell just by how tightly this is in that if I pull this one too badly, it's going to pull out the roots, and so this is one that I will actually trim off. There we go. Now be careful when you're in your flower bed, because there are plants that could be coming up and you don't want to step on them or injure them anyway. Even though what we were doing was spring trimming, when you find something that you know is not good to have in your garden, take it out as soon as possible so it doesn't go to flower and create hundreds and hundreds of seeds. That's what I'm doing today. This is Dame's Rocket. It looks beautiful. It looks like it's going to be phlox, which is the beautiful flower that opens up and smells so wonderful in your garden. This is not, though. This is an invasive variety. It's called Dame's Rocket. It has 4 petals on the flower. The real phlox has 5 petals. That's how you tell it. Plus, your real phlox will stay contained in its own little clump. This will spread. Now, even though last year I took these out before they flowered, here they come again. They don't give up. That's why they're invasive. So because the soil is so wet and their roots really aren't that deep, I can use a regular shovel. This is what the roots look like. Yep. Now this you do not want to put in your compost bin. This you want to put in the garbage. Bag it up and put it in the garbage. This is a tamarack. It's a tamarack bush as opposed to a tamarack tree. It drops its leaves, even though they are needles like an evergreen, it drops its leaves in the fall. So it's a deciduous evergreen, I guess, is what you probably would call it. We've had this now for, maybe seven years or so. Some years we'll get these beautiful little purple, tiny little purple blossoms on. Other years we'll get nothing. So as this is, they are still dormant. They haven't even started budding out yet, this is still a good time to trim them. And we want to do a rejuvenation trim and get rid of some of these really, really thick ones. There we go. I think this is good for now. But keep an eye on it. See if this encourages it maybe to bloom this year, as it has in the past. And because it's at the walkway, right next to our walkway, I don't want it to get so wide that it interrupts our being able to get through with the wheelbarrow and other equipment. So this will be good for now. These are Montauk daisies. They're in the chrysanthemum family. They are the very, very last thing that will blossom in the fall. They get this large, and I have to tie them up with ropes and baskets and twine just to keep them under control and from flopping over. So this is my year that I'm going to be chopping them back. I don't chop them back every year, but this is a chopping back year. I will go down to about a foot. You can see that they're already getting green down at the bottom. And so I know I don't want to go farther than that. As you can see, they're almost like a bush. They get so thick. And right now, at this point, this is again, it's a rejuvenating kind of clipping.
Well, you can see the new growth coming right off the branch there.
Yes, and these are some hefty branches for a flower. I think I'm going to need a bigger cage. I'm about done trimming here. Some of them I'm leaving taller, like these guys, because I do want to have some flowers this year. I think I'll have flowers on all of it, but just to be sure, I wanted to leave some taller ones. And we were lucky enough when we were trimming around the base to find some that had rooted. So I will be planting these up and having a new Montauk daisy bush someplace else. And while I'm right in this neighborhood, I'm looking at the red twig dogwood, and I can see that there are some branches here that are already dead, so I'm going to take those off and trim out anybody that looks like it's going to be a problem.
Well, you can distinctively see the difference in color.
Yes. And then we'll dispose of this. This can go in the compost bin. There's nothing wrong with this wood. It's just that it's seen its day. So it's time, and could be weather related. And these are the hardy hibiscus. These two get to be 5 feet, 6 feet tall, and have the beautiful dinner plate size blossoms on them. And every year you cut them back all the way to the ground if you like, because they will come back and grow all of that distance in 1 year. Now these are a little bit more substantial than the fleece, the giant fleece, but easily broken, easily put in a chipper or broken up by hand to put in your compost bin or use as mulch just the way it is. It looks like it's been cut back way, way drastically. These can go all the way to the ground because no new growth grows out of here. What you don't want to do is be pulling on them or pulling them out if they're not ready to budge, because you would disturb the roots of them then, and that would be harmful to the plant. As they dry out, they will break off easily and be all cleaned up. You won't be able to see them anyway once they start growing because it'll just be so full. But this is a perfect place to take a picture of where these daffodils are growing and how they're interfering and growing into the roots of the hibiscus. So once the daffodils are finished and they've turned brown and gone down, then we know that it's time to take those out of here and move them to someplace else. This is a trumpet vine that is just getting way too straggly. Our hope was to have it go along the fence line and up the trellis a little bit, but last year it really did it well, and so we're going to trim it back some, and maybe we'll have to trim it again during the year, but for right now I'm just taking anything that is taller than the trellis. This is a willow bush. And in order to keep it from getting scraggly, I want to cut it back. It's already starting to sprout out, so it's a good time to do this. Now we're looking at our semi-dwarf peach trees, and we do not want them to get away from us like our last ones did. So we're going to be keeping them about this height, a little bit taller than myself. So I'm going to take that off. And now I'm looking for anything that is growing in the middle, because I'm after a vase-shaped opening. So these guys have to go. This little guy's gonna go. We don't want him. We're gonna have our main split right here right there. So anything that looks like it's gonna be growing inward has to come off. Okay. What you're looking for also is a branch that comes off at a 30 to 40 degree angle here. You don't want a branch that's going this way at a 90 degree angle, because once it gets fruit on it, it's just gonna bend down and break.
So nothing horizontal.
Right, you want something that's stronger. It's gonna have some tension on it, so when it gets fruit, that it'll be able to hold the fruit up. And you're looking for anything that looks like it might be crossing over another branch, or it's diseased. These all look pretty good. This one maybe comes off. And if you're in doubt, if it doesn't come off when you first try it, clip it off, don't rip it off. Oh, that's nice, I like that. Clip it off, don't rip it off. Now, we have a half an acre, and that's quite a bit, but it's not the largest place. As you can see, there is a lot of work that has to be done. There's grasses that need to be cut down to the ground, and there's old flower heads and another giant fleece bush, which I did end up cutting back some of the ways. Those all need to be trimmed. This is the forsythia. This is one that you do not want to trim right now. This is going to bloom, except I'll take this. This is going to bloom in the spring. So anything that's going to bloom in the spring, like forsythia or lilac or I can't think of the name of it, don't trim it until after it blooms. Your yard will wait for you for a certain length of time. There's no reason to overdo yourself, because you're going to want to, you're going to feel all energized, the sun is out, it's wonderful, you see so many things that need doing. So just pick one area, take care of that area, and then sit down and rest, or go on to another area if you're up to it. But don't take the fun out of it by making it a job or drudgery, or getting all worn out doing it and then you can't enjoy it. So I hope you've learned something from this. I hope you enjoyed it. Please give us a thumbs up. We enjoyed having you visit with us. If you have a question or comment, please send it along. And if you'd like to join our garden family, please subscribe. Bye for now. You're doing good. I'm waiting for you to blossom. Remind me of my mom.
Connect with us on YouTube.